What is good, guys? Back on SPL, this time with a weekend match between Black Albion from the Classiest and P2 from the Tigers. Medicham and Greninja both are big threat to P2's team. His water resist is his own Greninja, and Celesteela has like a pseudo water resist if it's spit death, but I think it can only switch in once, so it's not a counter at all to Greninja. I do think the Greninja has 4 attacks on Biothad because spikes are most likely on the Ferrothorn. And yet, the Medicham, when it comes in on Zygarde, Heracross, or Heatran, it kind of just gets a kill. I definitely think Bio has a better matchup. He has 2 big threats to P2's team. And P2's Mons can be kept in check. Like, the Zygarde can be checked by Clef on Lando. Heracross can be checked by Clef. And it also doesn't want to switch in on much. It can only come in on maybe the Ferro or the Lando. That's about it. The Heatran has to be the rocker on P2's side. This Greninja could be Scarf, and we see Greninja with his Clefable lead. I would say that the Clef is probably the rocker on Bio's side. That would mean Heatran gets the extra move slot, so Magma Storm Taunt off par is most likely set in stone, and the last move could be a filler. Options would be Toxic or Flash Cannon, but we will have to see what the last move on Bio's turn is. Yeah, the Ferro most likely spikes Leech Sheet Power with Knockoff. Lando most likely Scarf. Now, Bio could either go for Rocks, because P2 probably doesn't have Hazard Control unless he's Defog Coco. So I would understand completely if Bio just wants to get up Hazards, because I think he can live any one hit. I think he can even live a Gung Shot if he's max defense, and if it's Protein Grand. But yeah, if he's fearing a Gung Shot, he could also just go into his Ferrothorn here. Ferrothorn would just scout out the Greninja set in general. The only problem would be if this is like Low Kick or HP Fire Protein Ninja. Because then it's a huge problem for Bio if it has Gung Shot and if it has a Low Kick. But yeah, if I'm P2 here, I would consider going for Spike if he has that. That covers the Ferrothorn. And if Bio stays in, I think he would just go for Rocks. I don't think he would go for Moonblast. Yeah, like Bio would either stay in and go for Rocks, or he would switch into Ferro. So I think Spikes is a fine play for P2. Or going into Heatran is another fine play if he doesn't have anything to hit this Clef with. And yeah, let's talk about P2's team. The Zygarde is most likely Bandit. That's like the set he uses the most. Celesteela, I would say mixed defensive, more so speed def probably. Standard set, Protect, Leech Sheet, Heavy Slam, Flamethrower. Either Ninja or Coco have to be Scarf. Not sure if I said that already. Heracross is going to be a SD variant, either sub-SD or SD3 attacks. Yeah, I think I said everything about the teams that I wanted to say, so... We see it's a Battleborn Greninja, he goes for Pump, and Bio just throws up the Rocks. So that damage tells us he's... That was either a low roll, I think he specs Autoclave has some sort of Spadef investment. Now, Bio is either gonna go into his Ferro or into his Greninja here. P2 could make it double. Yeah, he does double. He does double in the Heatran expecting the Ferro Zone. But Bio goes in the Greninja, makes a good play because that covers the Heatran and it also covers the Stain. Him going Greninja on the opposing Greninja makes me think he has a move to hit opposing Greninja. So that means he might have U-turn on this, right? Because he brought in, and if P2 stayed in and he couldn't hit P2's Greninja, then it would be a bad play by Bio. So I'm pretty sure he has a move to hit P2's Greninja based off that. So now Black Ovian can just fire off a pump here if he has that. And P2 doesn't have a switch in. I guess he can go Celesteela. That might be able to take 2, but Rocks are up, so I'm not sure if it can take 2. So there's the Steela, there's the Pump. We see it's Battleborn, and that's definitely choice specs. Now he's kind of forced to protect. Bio can take advantage and go into Heatran. As he does go into Heatran, yep. Now he could double into Clef, or he just. Okay, he just off powers. P2 protects there to get more lefties. Now, P2 is definitely gonna have to go into his Zygarde. So, Black Olivian can either attack to get chip damage on Zygarde, or he could pull a double into either Medicham or Clefable. So, he pulls a double into Clefable, expecting the Zygarde. Good play by Bio. Get some lefties. He's still in range from a Bandit 1000 Arrows, though, so now he's forced to switch into Landris here. But just getting the lefties on Clef could be nice for later in the game. If he doubles it in again, then Clefable can get back healthy, and if Greninja from P2 side locks in the Dark Pulse, the Clef could heal on that. I assume we see a U-turn from Bio here, because since the Zygarde was at -1, U-turn out was completely fine. And if P2 switches into Celesteela, Black Olivian gets momentum. So now he can go into either... So he goes into Clef to get more lefties. I was gonna say he could have done that, or he could have gone to Medicham. Now, I will lead shit here on P2 because I think it's pretty obvious that Black Olivian just wants to pivot into Heatran. He just wanted to get lefties on Clef, and now he can pivot out most likely in the Heatran. So let's see if he heavy slams or if he lead sheets. He does heavy slam. Now, P2 is either gonna go Zygarde or he's gonna protect here. So he does protect. Bio off powers again. Now, Zygarde is gonna come out here. Black Olivian could double in the Medi, or he could just get damage on Zygarde. I guess Greninja is also a potential double if he has Ice Beam on that. So there's the Zygarde. And he goes for Hidden Power. Ooh, Hidden Power Ice. So that's his last move. I said a team preview. It's probably Magma Storm, Earth Power, Taunt, and Filler move. And the Filler move was HP Ice. I obviously did not see that one coming. So there's a 1000 arrows bringing the Landris super low. But Black Olivian can just U-turn out here. On the Celesteela, did he U-turn? Yep. And now he can go Medicham or Greninja and pretty much get a kill. So that's the Medicham. I mean, P2 might protect here, expecting a high jump kick, but I don't think Black Olivian loses much from clicking high jump kick. Even if P2 protects, the next turn, then he can high jump kick again. And he doesn't necessarily need the Medicham at full for anything, so what did he go for? That's a protect. Did he fake out? He went for high jump kick. Yeah, I mean, I understand that play. I might have made the same play. Like, I completely understand where he's coming from, because P2 might have played the fake out and not gone for protect. But yeah, now you can just click high jump kick and P2 probably is gonna sack a Celesteela. Like, he doesn't have a switch in. He can sack the Zygarde, yeah, because the Zygarde is at, I think, 7 or 8% of the rocks. Yeah, you could sack the Zygarde or the Celesteela. Those are pretty much the options. I don't think he wants to go hard Coco and let it take like 70 or what. However, I don't know how much Coco would take from HJK, but it would take a fuck ton. Oh, also, since we saw the Greninja was probably specs on P2's side, right? I'm not 100% sure, like, from the damage on Clef, but I think it is specs. So I think the Coco has to be Scarfed then, which is really awkward. But, yeah. He used it already once, this SPL. So that's... I was kind of expecting that. He brought it with Poik, I think, in week 2. But yeah, as long as Black Olivian hits this high jump kick, P2 has to sack something. He could, yeah, like I said, sack the Zygarde, or he could try to go for double protect with the Celesteela. Well, Bio should have this game. He has rocks up. And whenever his Greninja comes in on, like, Heatran, it's gonna be bad for P2. And, like, P2's Ninja, Bio has a full health Pharaoh Sun that can keep P2's Ninja in check. He has Coco, he has Pharaoh for Coco. He has a Lando that he can sack to the Hera when that comes out to get the Intimidate. Like, he also has, yeah, he just has the better position here with Hazards up, and he's gonna get a kill here. Like, he has checks or answers to most of P2's Mon, and P2 just doesn't have answers for Bio's Mon. So there's a high jump kick, disconnect, there's the Zygarde sack. Now we see Coco come out. Now we see Bio has to switch here, right? P2 can just Volt Switch here if he has that, or U-turn, I guess. Ferrothorn is most likely play for Bio. Ferrothorn would let the Hera cross in, so he goes in the Heatran, gets crit. That crit obviously sucks. I think maybe this Hera, this is max speed Heatran, and it potentially outspeeds the Heracross, and he didn't want to let the Heracross in. That's why he went Heatran over Ferrothorn, or maybe he was scouting for the Coco having HP fire. I'm not 100% sure, but I think he was trying to keep the Heracross out. And yeah, he goes in the Pharaoh there now. Maybe P2 could have doubled into Heracross there, because the Ferrothorn was, like, the Ferrothorn had to come out. Now Black Olivian could either go for Leech Seed, or he could go Clefable here. Clefable would cover P2 going into Heracross, and he's also locked into Dark Pulse if he stays in. So I think Clefable is a fine play here. So he goes Greninja. That also works out. That also works out fine. But I think if the Clef was out of Twit KO range, then he could have also tried to heal his Clef there. Now, he most likely has something to hit. Yeah, exactly. He most likely has something to hit Peter's Ninja Knight's U-turn, but it only does 48, so it's Battle Bond U-turn. Now, he can U-turn out into the Clef. And does Dark Pulse, because we know he's locked in, and now he can go for Softballed. P2 could, yeah, exactly, goes into Heatran. I was gonna say, what else is he gonna do besides Heatran or Celesteela? Now, P2 can get his rocks up, and Black Oblivion could go back into his Greninja. I mean, maybe he doesn't want to go Hard Ninja, because he already took a Dark Pulse. Yeah, he doesn't want to go Hard Ninja. Wait, P2's Heatran doesn't have Lefty, so it could be Z-move, right? He didn't get knocked off. I'm pretty sure he just doesn't have Lefty, so it has to be Z-move then. Yeah, staying is not the play here, obviously. He already got, he got his Clefable back healthy now, so it can check the Heracross again. Since he doesn't want to go Greninja, I guess he could sack his Landorus, because his Landorus, he goes Heatran, okay. So there are the rocks. I think he could have gone Hard Landorus there, because it would have either been a sack, or if P2 goes for rocks, then he could have gotten it in before rocks. But now, this is a potential speed tie. I don't know if Bio wants to risk this. So I think he should just sack his Landris to rocks. That's what I would have done in the first place, going Landris there. Because you either get it in on rocks, or you just sack it to, like, Magma. But if he goes for something that is not Magma, then he would have forced out P2's Heatran with the Landris. So I don't think it would have been a bad play to go into that. But yeah, it goes not into Greninja, which is the correct play, because that was... Took already a Dark Pulse, if I recall correctly, from P2's Ninja. P2 doesn't have Switch Ins either, because his Zygarde went down. So P2 might just have to risk the speed tie. How healthy is P2's Ninja again? Oh, it took a U-turn, and it took... I think it took rocks as well. So P2's Ninja is low, he doesn't have a Switch In yet. So P2 is probably going to just off-power here, hoping to win the speed tie. But yeah... Bio has the option to just sack the Lando and not risk the tie, so I think he should definitely take that sack. Because this Trent, if it outspeeds the Heracross, that's nice, and it also obviously is his main way of killing the Steela. I mean, the Steela is not a big problem, because he also has can beat it with the Greninja and with the Medicham potentially. So he does just sack the Landorus to rocks, that's the correct play. Now he can go in the Medicham and click High Jump Kick. Or he can go Greninja and click Hydro Pump. But I would go Medicham and click High Jump Kick. Because it's 90% accurate. And I think, yeah, Hydro Pump is 80%, right? So I would definitely go to Medicham. On the other side, if he goes Greninja and connects the pump, Greninja kind of just wins. So I could also see him doing that. But like I said, I would go with the more accurate move. High Jump Kick 90% over the... 80% Hydro Pump. So there goes Greninja. Okay. Yeah, he just has to connect the pump here. Like, I don't know if Water Shuriken would kill. So I would definitely pump. If he has Surf, that's also cool because it can't miss. But I'm pretty sure he doesn't have that because he already showed Hydro Pump early on the Celesteela. He showed U-turn. So his other two moves have to be Dark Pulse and Water Shuriken. Yeah, so its moveset is pretty obvious from that. So yeah, he pretty much has to click pump then. Because if Water Shuriken doesn't get enough hits and then he loses his Greninja, that would be awful for him. P2 has to sack something, but what does he sack here is the question. If he sacks this Heatran, then he only has Celesteela left to deal with the Clefable. So I don't know if he wants to sack the Heatran, but he... Doesn't have a switch in. He sacks Celesteela, okay. So now even just misses, he gets another chance, but he hits the first one. Now he gets his Battle Bond. P2 is forced into Coco here. I guess Heracross might take one, but yeah, Coco comes out. Yeah, this pretty much confirms that he's Choice Scarf, because if he's not Scarf, he would just die to Pump here. BO scouts for Scarf Coco. Goes into Ferrothorn, there's the Volt Switch. I'm actually not sure if it is Scarf, because that's 16%. And the Volt Switch crit on the Heatran earlier also did a lot. But I guess Bio was just not risking the miss in that scenario. Even if he knew that if it's Scarf or not Scarf, I'm not 100% sure from that damage. From that damage, I would actually think that it's not Scarf because that did a lot. But maybe the Pharaoh is a bit... No, the Pharaoh is a bit dev. So Heatran can click Magma Storm here. Bio goes into his Heatran. And now it's just a speed tie, and Bio wins the tie, but it doesn't really matter, because if P2 won the speed tie, then Black Oblivion would have just gone into Greninja and clicked Water Shuriken, and Greninja just wins at this point. He just has to get some chip on Heracross, and then Greninja wins with Water Shuriken. So I don't think that mattered that BO won that speed tie. He was willing to sack his Heatran, I'm pretty sure. So now P2 goes into his Ninja. Black Oblivion is forced into his Ferrothorn here. And yeah, P2 can predict that and go for Dark Pulse. But it doesn't matter because the Ferrothorn, I'm pretty sure, is out of range to get 2-hit KO'd. And even if it's not, even if it's in 2-hit KO range, then he can still go into Clef if P2 locks in Dark Pulse. And BO also has more sex, and it's just way in his favor at this point. I don't see him losing. So there's the Ferro. Okay, yeah, it is in 2-hit KO range. Okay, it was already chipped. So now you can just go into Clefable. And P2 doesn't even have a good double that covers the Clefable. He does double in the Hera. Because, like, if he doubles in the Kogo there, the terrain would end. And if he doubles into Heracross, that's completely fine for BO, because BO can just click Moonblast now, get damage on the Heracross. Moonblast doesn't Oko, but it's got damage on Heracross. That means Greninja just wins with Water Shuriken. That's all the damage he needed. And now he can switch out, sack the Ferrothorn, exactly. As soon as we see a Rock Blast, Rock Blast does connect, and now he can just go Greninja or Medicham, but I think Greninja just wins the game now with Water Shuriken. Because everything is in range, I'm pretty sure. P2's Ninja is super low, it also has to take rocks. Coco has to take rocks, it's at 60-ish, so it also dies to Specs Rushing. He said CTC let me down. Was this a CTC team that P2 brought? I'm not sure. I mean, I have seen a team like this once on forums. I don't remember if it was by CTC. But yeah, Water Shuriken picks up the Ninja, and Water Shuriken is also going to pick up the Coco. So Bio takes the win. Classiest have not won a week yet, this SPL, I'm pretty sure. So let's see if they can win a week this time. BO is definitely positive. I don't remember P2's record. I think P2 was 3-3 before this, so now he's 3-4. I'm gonna pause it real quick and show you guys the score for this week. So now we can see here Black Olivian takes the win over P2, and the Classiest are up 4-2 versus the Tigers. And yeah, Black Oblivion is positive, but I don't remember his exact record. I think he only lost two games. Like, I think he's either 6-2 or 5-3, one of the two. I don't remember. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Like, P2's team was just kind of, I think it was like kind of matchup pick. I don't know, I didn't like it too much. It was pretty weak to Greninja. And like, it's not like, Greninja's like super common. It's not like it's like a mon no one uses. So I didn't like that it was weak to that. Like, Medicham on the other side, that was just, like, Medicham, you don't see it that often. So being weak to that is not, like, you can't always say, oh, you should have prepped for Medicham. Because Medicham is, like, I think it depends on your opponent. And BO, I don't think he has used Medicham much in the past. So P2 probably didn't expect him to bring a Medicham. But yeah, GG to both. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for more content, and peace out.